Okay, so this is going to be kind of a walkthrough of the injection molding process for the assignment for the Tech 4476 injection mold assignment. Not for injection molds in general, but for the purposes of this class assignment. All right, so let's see. We need to start off by putting in a. We need a block to start with. This is not going to be the blank. The blank is going to be a little bit larger than this, but for the most part, it's just going to be a block that's a little undersized. Let me just start with a sketch. On that plane is good, and I want to center everything on the origin like this. So I'll start with put a rectangle in here. Not that kind of rectangle. I want this kind of rectangle. Now, according to our assignment, we have a 4-inch maximum width for our block. The height in this case, we'll go with 2 inches. That's actually in the assignment. And we'll get our thickness in just a minute. All right, so we have this 2-inch by 4-inch block. Again, the 2-inch dimension is set in stone. The 4-inch dimension is a max, so you can go less than that. So if your mold winds up being nice and square, say, just a circular shape, you can go less than that. In fact, I don't know, I may do that, but 4 inches works pretty well, so we'll just go with that. Notice our sketch is fully constrained, and we'll just say okay. Let's go ahead and give this some thickness. Now our blank we'll be starting with, and that's not the way I want to do that. The blank that we'll be starting with is going to be 1 inch thick. And so if we let's go with feature curves. If we extrude this out 1 inch, then we'll be relying on the mill finish of the surface instead of a nice machined surface. And what we want is a nice machined surface. So I'm going to go with let's see, 0.98 inches thick. Let's see. Let me preview that. That's kind of going in the opposite direction that I want. It doesn't make a huge difference, but I just prefer it to go in that direction. That way I'm on the same plane as my original sketch. But that doesn't really matter. These are just this is Tech 4472 stuff that we're doing so far. And we'll just come in here and I'm gonna go with a pretty simple design. Let's see. I'll just go with a couple of diameters. Let me go ahead and get that one constrained. Slow. All right, so that's pretty close to an inch and a half, so we'll go with that. And inside here, we'll go something a little bit smaller. Yeah, I guess I'll call that an inch. All right. So this is going to be the cavity side of our mold. And so what we're going to do with this, we'll just extrude this out. And make this the cavity. No, that's not what I want to do. Let me do this. I'm going to pull them out individually, get a single curve. First, I'll do the major depth of this, of course, in the opposite direction. How thick do I want it to be? I don't know. I'm going to look for a shape, something like that. So, yeah, well, let me just go with an even 0.5 inches. And we're going to just explicitly say we want to subtract that. And let's see, this interior will go just a little bit deeper, say 0.75. Subtract that out. All right, so that'll be fine. Actually, yeah, that'll be fine. I'll just have to live with that. Let's see. All right, so now we need a couple of holes in here to position our alignment pins. So we'll go with our hole command. We'll put one there as it wants you to do. That's just always bothered me. And then I tell you what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna put one of them line up on the midpoint like this. And I'm gonna leave the other one up in the corner like this, maybe a half an inch off the edge. And let me go ahead and give these guys some dimensions. position in there. And this one I want a half inch off this other side. Remember, we're not slaves to these auto dimensions. Okay, so we're going to come in here and make this a half an inch off of this other side. I don't have to do the math. I can just plug it in. Half inch off of this side, and it's lined up with the center. That will help us to keep straight one pin from the other. Okay, and it will keep us from putting the mold together upside down or backwards or something like that, sort of a poka-yoke feature there. Finish that out, and let's make these holes a quarter of an inch in diameter. Let's see, 0.25, there we go. And that'll do. All right, so probably driving some of you OCD people nuts, but this is just going to be a little bit better for reasons that may become apparent later on. We want to make sure that we're getting the holes in the right position. In fact, we're not going to do that. Never mind. I was going to say later we could go ahead and jog this down and see the whole model update. And if you want to do that, that'll be fine. But we just need to get through this assignment. All right, so I think that's good enough there. Later on, we'll add the sprue in there and things like that. This is not how to create an injection mold from a solid that already existed. That's a pretty good project. That's more of a tool design project than what we're doing here. So I'm going to just offload that responsibility. We're just designing a nice simple mold here. Now, let's see. Oh, yeah, I knew something was bothering me about how deep this thing was. If I do this the way I'm doing it right now, I'm going to wind up with the other side. If this is the cavity side, then my core side still has to come out of a 1-inch block, and that means that it's going to have to go way up in here, and I'm going to be left with a really thin core side. So I'm going to backtrack a little bit and shrink these down some. So in this case, a 0.5 is a bit too much. I'm going to have that. And this other one was 0.75. I'm just going to shorten that one down a little bit. And that'll just make things a little bit friendlier for my other side of the mold. All right, so we'll save that. Now, what I want to do is I want to design these two halves kind of together, but I don't want them to all be in the same file. And so you guys know a good trick for this. I'm going to go ahead and just create a new parent. And we'll call this the mold assembly. That was my cavity side. This is going to be the mold assembly. And what I want to do now you see that I'm in the assembly. How you work this thing? There we go. So I'm in the assembly, and there is the mold cavity side. What I want to do now is make the core side. So I'll create a new component. And that will be my mold core side. Yeah, and I should have done a better job of naming my my parts. But anyway, now would actually be the time to fix that. But I'm not going to. All right, so I'm going to drop into my mold and model my mold side now. I'll go ahead and start with a sketch, the same as before. Put it there. All right, now I'm going to tie these two models together. I could use my wave geometry linker. Let's see. I think if I just go for broke and do a project curve and set my filter to entire assembly, let's see. So he's going to do this automatically. He says, you know, I need to wave link those two together. That will be fine. So I'm making this model dependent on the other model. But in this case, that's okay. So I'm just going to go with that. In fact, I can just grab all this geometry here and just steal it. Okay, so I now have this sketch that... where did he go? What did I do? Yes, 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 yes. Okay. All right. So apparently I forgot to hit apply or okay there. I got a little ahead of myself. So we'll say okay. Now I've got that geometry in there, and I can build my model based on that. I'll extrude this side. Let's see, I actually want those to be connected curves, so I'll extrude that. And that needs to be, I've kind of forgotten how much, I don't really know just yet, so let me just say okay for that, and I'll start building off of that. But when I'm done, I need to wind up with the whole thing being a half an inch. Let me see here. Do a section view in that direction, and I'll just do my extrude with that section view turned on. All right, so I'll home, I'm going to extrude out this bit here, and I'm going to go in that direction. Let's see, so now I need to determine what my wall thickness is going to be. So this is going to be the half inch, 0.5, minus whatever my wall thickness is going to be. Let's just go with 50 thou, okay. And then let me come up here and say I need to do my offset, a single-sided offset. Whoa. No, not 57 inches. Let me just look at that. All right, so I'm going, I've got the wrong direction going there, so I need to go a negative 50 thou. And now that looks a little better. So I've got my cavity side starting to come together. That needs to be united to the parent there. And so I'll say okay. All right, so that's part of my core coming together. And I'll now do the rest of my core. Comes off of this curve in the opposite direction. It is the quarter inch minus the 50 thou there, and my offset, come here, my single-sided offset. What'd I do? Grab the wrong stupid curve? Okay, so let me just grab the right curve and ungrab the wrong curve. There we go. That's a little better. And all right, so that looks good. So I'm going to say okay. And now I've got to go back and do the math and figure out how thick my block needs to be on the cavity, or the core side here. So I'll go, where is that? Analysis, measure. And I want to know the distance from this side to that. I've got a minimum distance there. 0.95. All right, so that's pretty close to what I was looking for. I need 30 thou more, though. So I'm just going to add 30 thou to this first extrusion to get things to be 0.098. Oh, and I can just do this, add 0.03. There. All right, so now I should have a block that's 0.098 inches tall. Did I get it? Yes. See how good I am? Okay, so there we go. And let me turn my section view off. All right, so now I need my, need to go ahead and poke some holes in there. So I'll go to my hole command. And this should be a little bit easier than last time even. And they go right there. They're a quarter of an inch. They go through the body. And we'll say okay. All right, so that's the two halves of the mold. And we can just take a peek here. Go back through the section. You can see it sectioned through like that. That's going to become our cavity. With something this small and this simple and with a nice clean surface finish that we're going to have, we're not going to need to be worried about draft angles in this case. Something that we, I do have some tapered end mills, but we're not going to worry about that for the purpose of this assignment, unless you're doing a senior project or something and you really need this to work well and come off really cleanly and easily. We won't worry about draft angles. We'll say okay there. And yeah, I think we are ready to move on.